everybody, welcome to another episode of Radio Free NeoTerra. You're here with Ash, and I'm here with Mike from Epic Duck Studios.
Hello, hello.
One of our local painter commission dudes. He's done commissions for Mini Wargaming and all kinds of other people. Who's the biggest commission you've ever done?
Guy out in Newfoundland keeps coming back with more work. I did a Tau Orca for him. I did a vlog of that, like, that was 5 years ago now.
It's like the size of a garbage can lid.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. Yeah. Tau Orca, did a Night Titan for him, a whole bunch of XV9 battle suits, Crute, cool. The Crute Rider guys, I forget the name of them. Yeah. Anyway.
The Crudoxes, like, or no?
Crute. No, the bigger
ones. Oh, the bigger ones, the Narlocks.
Narlocks, that's it. Yeah. Like,
cool.
I'd probably like a third of what I've done is that one guy, which is kind of crazy.
That's awesome. Well, anybody who's asking me to paint stuff for them, email Mike, because I don't do painting commissions. I hate painting.
And I don't do any until about June, so just wait a little.
Get in the queue, I guess, is what I'm going to say. Start lining up now. So we're going to play a 200-point game. Again, I'm like the guy teaching people to play Infinity right now. So you just watch me teach Adam from Greenleaf how to play. Actually, I'm the guy teaching people who do painting commissions how to paint Infinity, apparently. So now I'm going to teach Mike how to play. He's read through N2, and he hasn't played N3 yet. I've learned some stuff about teaching people how to play on camera, so hopefully this game is a little less like rules forgetful than the last one we played, where I didn't read what Adam's army list was and we forgot like what half his stuff did.
Nice.
It was a video. I put it up anyway. Whatever. It was fine. So he's gonna be playing Nomads again. I'm playing my Toha this time, and we're gonna throw down 200 points of Supremacy. So Supremacy, quadrants plus consoles. I'll walk you through the mission. We'll take a look at his beautifully painted army, and my adequately painted army, because I painted it in like a day. And then we're gonna get started. So we'll see you in a sec. All right, so here we have 200 points of Nomads. So this was Mike emailing me, being like, do I have an army? and we figured it out, we made it work. So we have a Reverend Codicier, Custodier, there we go, in
Custodier.
And she's got ODD, Hacking Device Plus, and a Combi Rifle. We've got a Hellcat HMG, or is it the Wildcat HMG?
That's the Hellcat HMG.
That's right. Yeah. We have 4 Del Morlock Group, and they're all armed with combis, because we need to make up the point somewhere. So yeah, we know, chain rifles are better, but combis are where it's at, because that's what he had painted. And then we've got the Iguana Pilot and the Iguana. Very cool miniature. You've probably seen Adam use it in our last 2 games here, but he's just awesome, and it's cool to play with him again. And we're going to get the dispersion rules right if this guy ejects, I promise, this time. So there it is, 200 points of Adam's, or sorry, Adam, last game, Mike's Nomads. And here's my 200 points of Toha. We got a couple Tridents, we got a Go Ryo with a Kamau and a Mikhail. We've got a Kumateo Bioengineer with a Kamal and a Mikhail. And then we've got a Chax Auxiliary with HMG, Neurocinetics, and his awesome visor. And then we've got a Clipsos FO. I could just not show you this and deploy it in hidden deployment with a marker, but then you wouldn't get to see the pretty models. So that's what we're doing. And I've got a Nicool Ambush Unit with his cool Viral Sniper. He's a sapper, so he digs in and creates his own cover. And then Artichoke Beyonce, as she's called, which is the Toha Delegate. She can get used as an HBT, or she can get used as a Specialist. I'm using her as a Specialist this time. And that's my 200 points of Toha. All right, so here's our 4-foot table set up for Supremacy. Once again, we're playing after work, so this is my table. This is the Ash collection of scenery on a very cool mat that Frontline Gaming sent me. So once again, this is the High Tech City mat. These people were asking me where it came from. Frontline was nice enough to send me a mat for my channel. And I am using a variety of shark-mounted lasers. That's the Dexter Schiller MDF building company, if you guys have been looking at who won the ITS 2014. Nice guy from Denver, makes some very cool buildings, so they think these are his buildings right here. And then lots of Bandua buildings. These are some of the leveled Bandua buildings, the stackable ones in a couple different colors, and a variety of other companies' containers and trees and crates. And so it's like Microet Studios and all kinds of stuff. So now Supremacy is the 4 quadrant mission. So 1, 2, 3, 4 quadrants in the middle of the board. Each round you're trying to dominate them. If you dominate the same number as your opponent by having the same number of or more points in each one, you get 1 objective point at the end of the round. If you dominate more of them, you get 3 and your opponent gets none. So, kind of big deal there. Then there's also consoles that can be hacked. You can hack them with a Specialist at -3 to your willpower. Or if you're a hacker, just hack them straight up at a straight willpower roll. And we have 4 of them at the end of the game. Whoops, you get objective points based on how many if you've hacked the most, basically. And if any are contested, then you do willpower rolls afterwards. So we're gonna roll off right now to see who the first player is and who is choosing deployment. And we'll make a face-to-face roll.
All right.
I get an 8, and I pass. 10. You get a 10, and you pass, I assume. So you beat me, you cancel my 8, and you can choose. Do you want to choose who goes first, or do you want to choose deployment order and where you're going to set up?
I'll choose deployment order.
Okay, cool. So who's going to deploy first and where are you deploying?
I will let you deploy first.
Okay, and you get to pick your zones. You get to pick where I set up.
All right. No, I'll take this side.
Okay, so you're going to deploy over here. That means I'm going to be setting up opposites, and we'll be back after deployment. All right, so here's deployments. In this building, which the tops lift off of, which is pretty cool, I have one of my tridents with the Galrail, the Kamal, and the Macau. Macau right here is the whatchamacallit, the link leader. Again, Macau link leader, Kamal, and my Kumateo, bioengineer. And we've got Artichoke Beyonce, the diplomat, hanging in that squad. Neurosynetics HMG up top, and then a cool sniper. I have a lot of great places for him to entrench, but I can see a guy over here, and I can see this console. So this is Sniper Town. Don't come to this alley, and hopefully you will die. And I can kind of see down that alley as well, so that's my thoughts behind deployment. So there that is. Across from me, I've got one of the Morlocks up here on the roof, another Morlock, the Iguana, another Morlock, and the Reverend hanging out behind this side right here. So the Hellcat off table. And of course my Calypso somewhere in here infiltrated. So I get to choose who goes first or second. And if I was a huge jerk, I would make Mike go first and then use a command point to strip two of his orders. So that he would have like three orders for the turn. But I'm not gonna do that. I'm just gonna go first. You need to make a choice. Do you want to use the command points to strip my orders?
Yes, I do.
You do, okay. So leaving three to try and, we'll flip over two here, to try and conserve his irregular orders and make them Rambo-y if he needs to activate the Iguana. So that's my first turn. Let's see. Well, let's start off by flipping an order. And we're going to activate this link team. And they're going to make a short move. Now they're inside the building, so we know that nobody can see them. First short skill, they're going to move. So his intent is to move up along the wall to here. So that's two and four. It's the link leader. He'll end up there. He'll end up in behind. And he'll end up behind him, like so. So we're check for arrows. All right, so with a 14 or less, I'm going to throw a grenade right here. And two is going to hit. And it's going to put a smoke grenade, right like that. So there'll be another order now. And they're going to get another short movement skill. And we're going to use it to move. So we're going to go
okay,
two
smoke ups like an
and two. That's right, so it'll block line of sight, which is pretty handy. He's going to go four up to here, and he only moves 4-2. And this one's going to come out 4 inches up and behind. And then my second sword skill, because there's no arrows being generated here, we're going to move up to the wall, like so.
Okay.
We're going to move 2 more inches towards the wall, just over there. And then the Kamal's going to move 4 inches up to the wall as well. All right, so again, they're going to take an order on the link leader, and he is going to do a climbing order to move up the wall. So it is a 3-inch wall, so I have lots of room to move up to here and engage the console. Now, I think he might be able to see me. Want to check? I'm pretty sure he can.
Actually, I can't.
No, well, let me put my template down. See again?
In that case, yes, I do.
Yes, okay. So now I'm going to remaining move everybody else. He can climb up to 4 inches, so he's going to climb up to here. And this guy, I don't know, I think because of the coordinated order, they're making a long movement skill. He actually says stand where he is. But I'm not sure about that. I'm going to look it up. We checked the arrows here. There's not one getting generated. So he's going to take a shot at him. This fella, because he's not in base contact with the building, can't make the climb, so he just does nothing. So go right ahead. That was my long skill, so I don't get anything else. You can just make your shot.
All right. So I want to just make under ballistic skill 11.
Okay. I am not in base to base with cover, so it's a straight 11 range. Plus whatever your range is. So I think you're minus 3 because you're over 60.
Yeah, we're at 18.
Okay, so 11 minus 3 is 8. One shot. Cranks it with a 7, so I'm going to get an armor roll. I'm armor 1, so I have to beat a 12.
I did miss the box, though.
That doesn't matter. I take a wound. I am now unconscious. That's going to break the link. Those guys go away, but people are at least where I want them to be. All right, so spending another order over here now, and Artichoke Beyonce is going to get to work. And she's going to go 4 over to here as a first short skill. I'm pretty sure nobody has any arrow at this point.
No.
All right, and she's going to go 4 again up to here. Flip another one, and she's going to base-to-base the console and make a willpower test. It is marked as belonging to Toha. All right, next up, we're going to flip another order. This gentleman is going to move, well, going to make the Kamal again, the Macaw, the link leader. And he's going to move 4 inches to here.
you're not
getting the arrow from me there. Okay. He's going to move 4 inches up to this box. Like so.
If she were like 1 millimeter that way, then
she
could see him.
Then she could see him.
And then just clipping the edge of this.
The what you call it? The Kumatail is going to move 4 inches over to here. Second short skill, they're going to move again. He's just going to stay where he is. She's going to move 4 up to here. And the McCall troop, or sorry, the Kamal troop is going to move 4 to here. And in order to activate that link, we're going to go 4 and hang it back here. We're going to go 4 and hang it right here. We're going to go to remain in zone of control.
Excuse me.
So we're going to go 4, whoops, up behind here, like so. And then second short skill, where he's going to get back in zone of control. Go to there. And be facing like this. He's going to go to here. And be happy. Last regular order, the Galrail, no longer part of a link, is going to move 4 inches up to here. I don't think that's going to generate any arrows.
Probably not.
So 4 inches up to here. Okay. Another 2 inches just to put himself.
Yeah, that wall blocks the whole thing.
Okay. All right, to there. Like so. There's all my orders. And that's turn set up. We've still got the Neurocinetic HMG up here, the Nakul down here hanging out on the ground floor. We've got a downed Kamael, or Mikhail rather, and a smoke grenade's now dissipated. And then a Kamal, a McCall, who's downed the Galrail over here. These guys setting up a little ambush, and that's it. So let's go over to Toa, turn one. So starting off with the Impetuous orders, all the Morlocks being Impetuous, will start running towards me.
All right. So now I've got climb plus on this guy. Does that mean he has to jump down this wall and basically
run, right? Yes.
Okay.
So, but he can do two. He can do a move because of his climb plus, because he can do it as a short skill. So you can go down 4 inches, no problem.
Okay.
Yes, that's
beautiful. And then move his second short skill if you want. So he's gonna hop over there. Now right. I don't think I could see anybody except for with this guy right here, Mr. Vow Sniper, because that's where I deployed him, was where I could see at the start of the game. So he's going to ARO Chucha, because okay. Why
so
wouldn't I?
So I guess I'd be getting cover from this dumpster thing.
No, you have to be in contact with the cover.
Oh, right.
So
yes.
Unfortunately, no cover. So he's going to shoot you. He is at good range, because he's over 16. Within 16, and a gajillion with a sniper is plus three. And he's BS 12, 15 or less. Let's see if I crank it or not. Blue dice, Ash, blue dice. That's a one! So now you can, we really should have had you declare your second short skill, and I assume that would be to dodge.
Yes.
So what's your physical?
Physical on him is 13.
Okay, so you can go ahead and do a physical of 13 or less. Basically roll between 2 and 13 and you dodge it. 3 you do, so you cancel my 1. That goes away. Now because it's your active turn though, you don't get the move during your dodge. You just get to basically,
okay.
You get out of the way of the bullet, but you stand there afterwards.
Okay. Right,
next Impetuous order.
Alright, next Impetuous order is just going to be him, I guess. Now he's got move 8 from Metachemistry.
Yeah. We have 2 climbing pluses, a move 8, and what was the other one?
The other one was no wound in cap.
Nice.
So yeah, there's the full speedy. 8.
There he goes. So I have nothing that can see you, so go ahead and make your second short skill.
Okay.
Which would be, I guess, to move again towards that guy.
Yep, so this time it's going to be a 4, that I guess is kind of like crank around the corner a bit.
Yeah, now I can see you as you come around the corner.
Yeah.
So I'm going to take a shot at you as you come around.
Fair enough. All right, go ahead.
And that's going to be on a... Well, he's got a Spitfire. I'm BS 12, and I believe a Spitfire is at 0 within 8 inches, and I'm certainly within 8 inches. So that's going to be... Not a weapon chart.
Somewhere on this
Here's
one.
A weapon chart. And it starts with S. Yeah, so 0. So 0 mod, I get 12 or less with one shot. 14 is going to miss. Next Impetuous, you got the other
right,
Morlock.
Next Impetuous.
Yeah, so I think he's still your closest dude.
Yeah, he is closest. And that one doesn't have move plus or anything, so
nope.
It's just a straight up 4. Yeah.
You get climbing plus though, so you can hop that wall for free later on.
Yep. Okay, so there's the first 4.
Yep.
And then just 4 again.
Right to the wall.
Oh,
yeah.
We got the. Yeah. So basically hugging the wall.
And setting up the ambush for later. So the closest model for this Morlock is this Kamal over here, so just making a beeline for him. You can just go 8 because nothing can see you.
Ooh. Let's try not to knock the terrain over. Actually, you might see me with.
With Mr. Nakul. Oh, actually, yeah, I think you're right. I think I set him up that way. And. I can, just. So one shot again, not in cover, needing a 15. Seven's gonna hit you. So now it's a viral sniper rifle. And that means damage 15 versus your BTS. What's the BTS of a Morlock?
BTS of a Morlock is zero.
Okay, so you have to go against damage 15 or you melt into goo. And this is your known wind incapacitation one, yeah?
Yeah.
Unfortunately, because you don't go unconscious when you get hit with viral ammo, you just melt. So don't melt. Roll a 16 to 20. 20! Laughs it off. Doesn't care about my nanobots at all. Now the regular turn starts, and you can start flipping orders or doing your regulars. Okay. You can also spend your 3 CPs if you want to make some of these irregular orders regular. And you do have Rambobot there. So he's going to take his irregular order to make a move into base to base with me.
Yeah, we got lots of room.
Oh, yeah, with 8 inches because of metachemistry. I will ARO by... I'm going to try and shoot you with my Spitfire again. Assume you're going to try and close combat me.
I am.
Okay. So I'm going to be shooting you, and then you're going to get a normal roll to hit me. So this is going to be normal roll against normal roll, because I shoot you as you come in, because I can shoot you at any point during your move.
Right.
And then you get to close combat me afterwards. So I don't think this is going to be face-to-face, because I'm shooting you before you even touch me.
Right.
So I need a 12 again, because I get no bonus with 8 inches. 18, I'm going to miss. So what's your close combat skill? Close combat.
Oh, sorry, CC, 22.
So you roll that dice and add 2. Anything over 20 is a critical.
Okay.
You get a 10, so you hit me. So what's your physical?
His physical is 13.
And what kind of weapon does he have? AP close combat weapon?
Yep.
That's going to have my armor. So my armor of 3 is going to go down to 2. And I have to beat your physical of 13. So that's going to go down to 11. So 11, or better than 11, and I'm okay. That's a 1, going to take a wound, and that's going to make my symbiote armor inactive. All right, so now he is basically at a reduced profile, but not wounded. So next order.
All right. I'll do the same, I think. No, she's regular move, but she's climb plus.
She's climb plus, yeah, so she can jump the wall as a short skill.
Okay.
I'm engaged, which means I can't target you.
Okay.
But unfortunately, you've got Johnny Sniper over here that can see you come over the wall.
Right.
So that would be bad. There's also an HMG, but he can't see that wall. So he's okay.
All right, so...
But you will definitely get Johnny Sniper if you walk over that wall.
Or here, and then jump the wall at that point.
There you go. So you're going to move 4 first, and then jump the wall as your second short skill. That makes more sense. So you're over there.
And that's that. So we're going to short skill, or rather move her over here, and then dodge on the short skill.
So that's your first short skill.
Yeah.
So I'll react by taking a shot at her with the sniper again. Okay. And now you're going to dodge your second one. So always wait to say what your second ARO is until after I've declared mine, or sorry, your second short skill,
because
you'll know what I'm doing. You're assuming I'm shooting here, right?
Yeah.
But I might not have. I might have just said I'll idle.
Okay.
So he's going to shoot you now, one shot. Now you're minus 3, or sorry, you're minus 3 for being in cover, but not until you hit it, so I can shoot you before that, which means I'm going to be at plus 3 to hit, because of my range. I'm over 16, so I need a 15 or less. 3's gonna hit you. So now you get your dodge versus a 3.
Okay.
So roll anything between 4 and I believe your physical is 12? 13.
13.
Anything between 4 and 13. You're good, so you cancel it again and get out of the way. Okay. Now again, you don't get your kinematica bonus here because she's not moving during her dodge because it's her active turn. Flipping a regular order, and the iguana's gonna climb as a long skill up to the top of here. All right, so now the only thing I have to can see, we just checked line of sight, the Nakul and the HMG can't see, is this Kamal. Now that was a long skill, so there's no second short skill. Okay. So I know I am safe to react by dodging. If I make my physical roll here, I'm just gonna go prone. So I'm a physical 12, 7, I pass. So she's gonna go prone and just hang out on top of that. Now going for some AD, the Hellcat's gonna jump in, placing the template anywhere it wants.
We're going to ground level. Place the template right in here.
Sounds good.
Does it matter which direction the one faces?
Nope. So one faces the center of the table.
Okay.
So for when you, if or when you fail.
Okay.
So not bothering with the assisted jump.
Not bothering with the assisted jump.
Okay. Because if you don't, he's got advanced or sorry superior, so it means he just ends up in his deployment zone.
Right.
So you can place him anywhere you want.
Right.
So now, if you wanted to be cheeky, you could go like this.
Okay.
And then place him in contact with cover.
Right.
Which would be nice.
Okay.
So it can't quite be touching, but you can place him right there.
Okay.
And that would mean you can see me. Or you could go like this down here, so you can't see me at all.
Right.
And then you can move up to the cover during your active turn if you'd like.
All right. Well, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to try that.
Okay. Now remember, the template can't touch it, so technically you're not in cover.
Okay.
Right? So you can get really close to the cover.
Okay.
Because the template can't touch it, you can't either.
Right. Okay.
What you might want to do is be out of line of sight, and then
because
you don't do anything else during this order except for arrive.
Okay.
You're free to move up to the corner and then shoot me later on.
Okay.
What's your physical?
Start spending that.
No, that's his own.
Oh, right.
You don't spend that order. That was his order. You spent the bottom on to bring him on, and then you make a physical test.
Okay. Sorry.
Only two regular orders in the order pool. That's right. Yeah. So you actually should have one regular order left then. Because you have your... The only regular troops that started were her and him right here.
Yeah.
So that puts you down to one, because that was... Sorry, because you've spent one regular order already.
Yeah, we spent one to climb the wall.
So this guy arrives. He doesn't spend this last order, though. Yeah. He just gets to show up with his own order.
I'm just trying to roll under 12.
You got it.
That'll do it.
Crank it, so you're going to land right there. Lieutenant order.
Yep.
And that's going to be the Reverend... what is it?
And she was Custodier. She was slow, right? 4-2?
She's 4-2, yep. So you can move to the cover, though, and lock down that console.
Lots of room.
You gonna peek out so you can lock down the console. There you go.
Okay. I'm gonna spend one to put him in suppression or suppressive fire.
All right, so that's gonna basically reverse how his bands are. He goes from being bad at close range and good at long range to good at short range and bad at long range, and that's gonna give him burst three.
And that's just because these guys are all in that nice 8-16 band.
That's right.
We assume
locks
they
down
might
zone.
Might be just out.
We'll see. Last regular, he's gonna move.
Yeah, so moving four.
All right, well I'm gonna move you as you go by or shoot as you go by with my Nicole. And I guess, what's your second short
score? Dodge.
Sounds good. So I get one shot at plus three, so I get 15. Crank you with a 12. So you have to beat a 12. I think your physical 13, you're going to need to crit here.
Yeah, fizz 13.
Crit! Nope, it's going to fail. So you get hit with a viral. It's damage 15. You are armor zero, I believe. Or one.
Armor one,
so you have to beat a 14 here. Oh no, wait, sorry, BTS, because it's viral. So your BTS zero. So beat a 15. Nope. So you melt and you ignore unconscious and go straight
to the zone. So he's a puddle of goo.
That was a pretty significant turn one. Both sides pushing into the zones here. Now, I believe you've left your deployment zone here, which is important because it means you're holding the zone. If you hadn't moved her up, then you wouldn't be in that quadrant.
Okay.
Because if you're outside 12, you're good. Yep, you're good.
Yeah, just a little outside 12.
So now you're in that quadrant, which means you're holding 1-2 quadrants, and I'm holding 1-2 quadrants. Okay. So we're both going to score an objective point, as opposed to me scoring 3 and you scoring none, which would have been a big deal. So our turn, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 regular orders left. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And lieutenant order. My impetuous regular guy is unconscious right now, bleeding to death, so he doesn't have to do anything. The other one is part of a trident, meaning luckily he's actually a trident leader right now, which means he's not going to have to run towards the end. Not spending an order, I'm going to reveal a TO camo marker that was hidden deployed to be right here. And it is going to move. Now this guy doesn't block any kind of line of sight, because he, or movement or anything like that, because he's knocked down right now. But I believe you can see it with him. Because I am as tall as a man. So can you check and see, we'll put the template down and see if you can see this marker?
Sure.
From where you is?
I cannot.
Okay, well then it's going to move. Its first short skill, which is 4. Down to this corner. Right here.
And now I definitely can see it.
You can definitely see it. Okay, what would you like to do? Now you can delay your ARO if you want to see what my second short skill is. But you can decide to dodge or spot it right now. Now if I do something that reveals me, your spotting test becomes irrelevant.
Okay.
Right? Or you can dodge in case I decide to shoot you somehow. Or you could just wait and see what I do.
Let's just wait.
Okay, probably a good idea.
Yeah.
So this thing is going to reveal itself and place a camo marker right here. We can see with this Morlock as well, so it can declare a skill. Can it see in the front 180? Where is it facing? Yeah, you probably can,
sort of
for sure.
Yeah, but it's, like, you can see, like,
would you like to,
that little sliver.
Well, you can delay as well with it.
We'll delay as well, then.
Okay. So I'm revealing, and I'm placing a mine right here. I would not lean on that table again. And that will reveal my Clipsos to be right here. Oh, you stay there, please. Oh, Clipsos. Not in the best going downstairs pose. All right, so now it's placed the mine as a second short skill, or mine. It's placed a camo marker. You don't know what it is as a second short skill. So what would you like to do?
I have no idea.
So what's the plan for arrows?
All right, she's going to use hers to dodge.
Okay.
Which gives me a free move for 4 inches.
No, you make a physical
test. Oh, got to make a physical test first?
Yep.
Okay.
Physical 13.
Physical 13.
Which you fail, so
we
she's
fail.
Still where she is.
Okay. And she doesn't dodge nothing.
That
and
guy
is going to fire.
So a suppression fire, you're going to get 3 shots against me. You're over 8, so you'll be at 0 mod.
Yeah.
Minus 9, though, for my cover and my TO camo. So what's your BS?
BS on...
probably 14, I'm going to guess.
Iguana is 14.
So you need 9s. Sorry, not 9s. You need 5s.
Okay, so we got 1.
Which is a crit, which puts me right to unconscious. And she goes unconscious, which was not what I wanted to happen. But that's life in Infinity. Well, that's not super fantastic, but such is life. So, these guys are kind of happy where they are. I think you need to go touch that console. So we're going to move into base-to-base with the console. This console was up against this a minute ago. And make a short, so she's going to crawl over so she's touching it, and make her willpower roll to try to hack it. Now she's at minus three because she's, well, I'm prone still. So yeah, I'm as tall as my base.
Okay.
That's why I only move 2 inches. Okay. And my willpower is minus three, so I'm at 10 or less. 17's going to fail. One more with feeling. Let's do this. 10 or less. There we go. So that console belongs to me too. All right, flipping some more regular orders. We're going to activate this link team. And this link team is going to move. We're going to go two and then two more in this corner with the link leader. Like so. We're going to go four with the Kuma tails there. We're going to go four with the Kamale over to here. It's my first short scale, so I don't think it generates any arrows because nobody can see me. Second short scale, we're going to move four again. So we're going to move four up to here. We're going to move four up to this corner right here. And we're going to move four. Actually, he's not going to be able to move that far because four is going to take me out of zone of control. So I need to move him back about an inch just to maintain 8 inches. Now, flipping another order. This link team is going to activate again. He's still link leader. He should have that marker on him. And they are going to go four just around the corner like this. I don't think you can quite see me with this big fella because I'm just hugging the corner here.
Probably not.
Okay.
Yeah, no, this next corner's in the way.
And then four more. Tossing a smoke grenade right there. I'm getting plus three because it's about 8 inches. I need a 14 or less. 20's gonna fail. So we're gonna spend another order and try it all again. So movements, these guys can go four. So they're just gonna come up in behind like this to hug in behind the link leader. And he's gonna try and throw another grenade. 13 is gonna crank it. All right, flipping another order. We're going to go up to this corner. So we're gonna make her the link leader now. Up to this corner, she's gonna go 4 inches, which won't quite get her in base to base with this thing. So it's gonna cost me one more order to do. And then he's gonna move up to here. Second short scale, everybody's gonna move again. Can you see me past the cloud?
I can.
Oh, I thought I put it in base to base. Okay, that's my bad. This got nudged as I was sliding underneath. There's actually up against these buildings. So yeah, so my next order, or sorry, my second short scale, everybody's moving to base, so we're still on that. Like so, and like so. Last regular order, she'll be the link leader again. And we will try and hack that console. Our 14 minus 3 is 11 or less. 18 is going to fail. And that leaves me with just my lieutenant order, which I will spend making this guy the link leader and revealing who my lieutenant is. And these guys are going to move for. He's going to move four back to here. It was a good try, buddy, but you didn't quite make it. She's going to move four back this way. And then second short scale, they're all going to move again. He's going to maintain cover. She's going to maintain cover back here. He's going to go 4 inches and maintain cover right here. And stands under control. All right, so Impetuous is happening first. And you've got one, two guys here, Impetuous.
All right, so we've got... Now, he's already in base to base, so is he just automatically attack?
That would basically be what you would do, yeah. You would just declare your first short skill to be idle if you want to see what my arrow is, and then you can attack me with your second one.
Okay, let's do that.
Okay, well, my ARO will be to dodge.
Okay.
And that means I can try and disengage.
Okay.
So I have a physical, I believe, of 10 or 12 now, because my armor's down. Close combat 22, so roll the dice and add 2. That's going to be a 13. So I have to crit here and get an 11 to beat it. 20, I fail. So you stab me with your AP close combat weapon. I have zero armor right now because my simian armor is inactive. And your physical is what, 13?
13.
So I have to beat a 13 here. 10, I'm unconscious. All right, so next Impetuous.
Okay.
She's basically split between these two guys here. I'm not sure if one's really closer than the other, if it matters.
They're both unconscious, so I think it's irrelevant. You can go whichever one you want.
We're going to go this way, and I'm going to pretend I don't know there's a mine there.
Okay, well.
Because you didn't tell me that.
It's going to go off no matter what. Go right kaboom. Ahead. So now so the. She's,
yeah, moving. The, short, first short skills will be moving 4 inches that way.
You got it. The anti-personnel mine goes off no matter what, and that is damage 13 and shock. So if you take a wound, you go straight to dead. So that means you are armor 1. Beat a 12 with one dice. You do. So, bam, you just ignore the mind to your face. So you can complete your move.
All right, 4 inches. Yeah, that'll almost get her base to base. Close enough?
Sure, yeah, close enough for me.
All right. You have climbing. I'm afraid of her chipping, so...
Yeah, it's fine. Just put her there, and then you step my neck with your second short scale.
Yes, but...
All right. Coup de gras.
But I can't do that till the impetuous phase, right?
No, or, that's your second short skill, so I'm right. Okay. All right, so there's the... Well, no, you still have your regular. Yep.
Yep.
And then you've got who left? Any more Morlocks?
There's this one back here.
Okay, so you're impetuous, which means you'll break your
cover. So she technically has to run this way.
Well, he's pretty close, too. I'm pretty sure you have to go towards Beyonce, because Beyonce is pretty close.
Yeah. All right, so we're going to get shot at.
Definitely by somebody, because this guy is going
to
be able to see
you. All right, so we're going to use first short to move 4 inches that way. Okay, just pop around the tree and...
Well, you can maintain cover with that tree during your move if you want.
But I have to go full four, right?
Just hug it. Yeah, you have to go the most direct route possible, but there's nothing keeping you from
maintaining contact with
that. Yeah, so I can go... So you're gonna break it at the end, though, and that's when I'll be able to see you.
All right, hang on. I'm just moving this for a sec. All right, so
now... the problem for me is when you break cover, I can no longer see you. Because you're behind that sign. So I'll get you in cover, which means it's a straight roll, plus 3, minus 3. So your second short skill is going to be to move again?
Yes.
Okay, so now that's going to bring you around this corner.
Yep.
And that means that HMG gets to shoot you.
Of course.
So, yeah. I'm going to do a take back here, because he didn't realize he could also just dodge and stop his movement, basically, over here. He has to make at least one short skill, but now that I'm shooting, he doesn't have to come around the corner right now. So... Again, he'll be in cover, because when he breaks cover, I can't see him anymore because of this guy right here. And that means I'm going to get a straight 12, 9. So you can try and dodge it. Your physical 13, so 13 or less. Get between 10 and 13, and you'll beat my shot. 16 is going to fail. So you take a viral hit, PTS 0, so try and beat a 15.
Nope.
Melt into goo. Hedge up! Blam! Sorry, you would have actually gotten the armor bonus for being in cover there, but that means you need to beat a 12, and you still rolled a...
Yeah.
Sorry, what'd you roll? You rolled a 16?
I think it was 16.
Then you win. Yeah, you're good. You're good.
You sure?
Yeah, that beats a 15. It's beat, not roll under.
Oh, okay.
Roll under and you die. Roll over and you're good. So you're right there and you're alive.
Okay.
I don't know what game we were playing for a second where you rolled high and it was bad. Armor for high, good. Low for hits, also good. It's strange because things reverse.
Yeah.
So is that all your impetuouses?
That is all 3 impetuouses. All
right. So you've got 3 orders in the order pool plus your LT. You have 3 command tokens left.
Right.
And you've got 3 irregular orders as well. So rest of your turn. Using a regular order to put the Hellcat here in suppressive fire.
Yep.
We did
dominating the zone.
That's where we had a suppression fire marker somewhere. All right, so 4 inches up the stairs with
her short scale.
Sure, it's right here.
Yep.
Just go to the 4.
Just right there.
Okay, so AROs. I will shoot you with a Nicole. Out of cover, because you're not touching it. I will shoot you with the Chax HMG. Would you like to use your next short skill?
Dodge.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, the Nicole, you're in the open from her, and that's going to be plus 3, so 15 or less. I'll crank you with a 3. What's your dodge? You get to apply this one dodge roll to all these shots.
Okay.
So, your physical 13.
Yep.
Cranked it with a critical. So, I have to crit now to do anything to you.
So
that misses because you cancel it. And I'm going to get 3 shots with the Chaxa HMG. Let's just check range. So in cover with the Chaxa. So I need to roll 15s here. And I have to beat this crit. So I have to get a 15 on one of these 4 dice to do anything.
And you got one.
I do. So I crit. The crits cancel each other. And that's that. So next order. 2 regulars left. And you've got some regulars still floating around.
Okay.
Regular over here.
Yep. So he, I guess, coup de grace that guy.
Okay, well, that's going to generate an ARO from him.
Okay.
Because I can see you, so I will shoot you.
Okay.
While you do that. So I'm going to let him take that one back and say instead that he's going to move and dodge. Because that's going to give him a roll against
this. Yeah, so we're going to move, just
back behind, yep. And then second short skill will be to dodge.
Apparently our models are interlocked here.
That's fine. And the dodge will get applied to that whole movement. So,
okay.
I get my shot. Again, you're in the open, so plus 3. So it's going to be 15 or less. Cranks you with a 10. Dodge on a 13 or less. 15 is going to fail. So you'll take a hit against your BTS. Beat a 15.
Nope.
No.
So he melts.
Getting melted by the viral sniper. Okay, a regular over here.
Yeah, and she's going to... No, she's kind of facing this way. I guess that's still in my 180.
You probably want to move first. It's still in your 180, but you're in the open.
Yeah, if I move, then the sniper's going
to
hit me.
That's also true. You could move up to this corner right here and not get shot.
All right, let's go ahead. So, yeah, move.
It's not going to help you against any of this resolved shooting, but it will help you later, potentially.
Okay, so move.
All right, so my area will be to shoot you with this.
Okay.
I can't see with anybody else.
And then my response will be to dodge.
Okay, now I'm inside zone of control. So I'm going to try and make a dodge to change facing with her as well. All right, so face-to-face, I get one shot with my Kamal over here. You get 3 because you have a combi, I believe. What's your BS?
Oh, I dodged. Didn't I?
I thought you shot.
Okay, well, let's shoot.
You can dodge. Or
no,
you
let's
shoot.
Go ahead and shoot.
You get 3 dice with shooting. You get but 1 dice with dodging.
Let's go ahead and shoot.
So you're going to get plus 3. I'm in the open. So you get plus 3 whatever your dice is. You're also in the open range. As you move over to cover.
We're at 14 inches.
Yeah. So I'm going to get 12 plus 3 is 15 with 1 dice. You get a, I think, 11 plus 3.
Yeah.
So 14 with 3 dice. So 3 dice, 14 or less. So 2 hits, 3 and 13. What do I get? I get a 10, so I'll cancel your 3, but you'll hit me with the 13.
Okay.
So I get 1 roll now. I have to beat a 13 here. I have armor 1, so beat a 12. Do with a 17. I'm already in cover, but I'll make a guts test anyway. 19, I fail. So I don't think I can, I'm already prone. I have no more cover to get to. So I'm going to just stay where I am.
We're going to move him over this way. So it's going to cancel the suppression.
He's going to do a climb or is he just going to move?
I'm just going to walk over.
Okay, so 6 inches is this gauge?
Yeah, I was just checking my speed was 6'4".
Yeah.
Okay, well, so yeah, whole thing.
So you technically can't go there because you can't fit your base. You're supposed to be on a 55 mil base.
Yeah.
And you can't place a model where its base can't go.
So but of course, I keep with a 40 that he also doesn't fit on.
I know. So you go right to the edge there, basically, and stop.
Yeah.
He's not good with stairs because he's a robot.
Oh, actually, sorry.
He's gonna
one sec. I just realized I moved wrong. I kind of wanted to go more like that.
Okay. So you're going like that.
And that now that'll trigger.
That'll trigger an ARO from my Kumatail. Yes, it will. It's also going to trigger an ARO from my. Nicole, he's going to shoot you with a sniper rifle. You can swear on my channel. Don't worry. I don't care about that. And then, yeah, this guy's still going to be blocked by the building. So no line of sight to him. So, AROs, you move for your first short movement skill. She's going to dodge.
Okay.
And he's going to take a shot at you with the viral sniper. So you get to just declare your second short skill now. What would you like to do?
All right, I'm just looking here. He can basically see both of them.
You got it. Now he's going to be minus 6 to hit, plus 3. He's got mimetism and cover because he's a sapper. He's entrenched.
Right.
She's in cover for minus 3 for your shots. Plus, she's going to be dodging.
Right.
3 shots into him and 1 shot over here into the Kumatail. So these are all face to face. So I'm going to get 1 shot plus 3 for range because up to 48, I'm in good range. And minus nothing because you're in the open. So I need a 15 or less. And I crank a 13. Now I am in cover plus mimetism, plus you're over 32, which should put your HMG at minus 3. We're just gonna double check that though.
We got weapon shirt.
Hey HMG. Hey machine gun. Yep, so you're at minus 3, so you're gonna be at minus 9 here. So you need 5. Now you did raw dog me with a 5 here to kill my Clipsos. So roll 2-3 dice and get a 5. I'm dead. You do, and you crit me.
Ooh, 5-3 to 1.
That's ugly. Doesn't even matter because I'm unconscious. So 2 armor rolls now for the 2 that hit. No, these get canceled by the crit. It's just the crit that goes through. So the crits cancel. I didn't crit you. You cancel me with a crit. I cancel those, and I'm unconscious. But you did good job, buddy. So you get 1 dice against my dodge. My Kumatail's physical is, I don't know, but we're going to roll dice and see if it matters. I roll a 8. 15.
That's going to be nothing.
Minus 3 for range. Plus 3. No, you're a 14, aren't you?
He's going on suppression fire.
Okay.
And she's going to do the same.
Okay, with the lieutenant
token. With her lieutenant token.
Sounds good. All right, so are we suppressing, and that ends turn 2. So now we're going to score objective points. I've got 12 points right here. Sorry, 13 points right here. What's he worth? I'm guessing more.
Hellcat. Hellcat is, I don't know where I find that right now. Hang on. 31.
31, so definitely more. So you've got 1. You don't have anyone in this one, though. This one's empty. So 1. You're contesting this one because she's 13.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, right. You've got this one as well, because he's only 5.
Okay.
Actually, check it. Hang on. Let's see my Kumatil is. And these guys are worth 13 and 12, so that's 25. What's the Moira worth?
Moira is worth 34.
34, okay. So you've got this one and that one. This one's empty, and I have one. So you have more than me. You're going to score 3 CPs, and I'm going to score 0. So you're going to go up to 4 to my one. First, going to flip an order. We're going to make this. Oh, sorry. Yeah, we're going to make this McCall, the Link Leader. And he is going to throw a grenade at the very tippy top of his range, 8 inches to here. All right, so 14 or less. Get it with a 9, so it's going to land. I'm going to drop another order and activate the Link. And they're going to move 4. So now I shouldn't have any suppression fire down on me, I don't think. Because I don't think the line can be crossed. Let's try.
I think we can get a line like through the console. Okay.
Then what we're going to do is...
Does the objective block line of sight at all?
The objective does not, no.
Okay.
So what we're going to do instead is we're going to move up with our first short skill, and we're just going to chuck another grenade through this line.
Okay.
To land right there. So 14 or less, I get it with a 10. So we don't have another template, but basically it's going to land right here and then block the rest of this access. Okay. Another order. This McCall is going to move 4 inches up to here. Oops.
And do a little dance.
Maintain the Link. The Kumatil is going to move 4 inches up to here. He's going to move 4 inches up to this corner. No, he's just going to stay there, actually. Now breaking the Link, this guy's going to try and murderize you with his gun. Actually, his viral close call weapon. What would you like to do?
Well, I can't see him, so I can't really do anything.
You can declare an arrow, because you're in base to base with me now.
Oh, okay.
So you can dodge, melee me. Whatever you'd like to
do. I'm assuming she's not really great at melee.
So I'm going to use my I-Cole and my martial arts at level 1 to enforce a -3 for to hits against me. So you're going to hit on an 8. I have a 22, so I get dice plus 2, basically. So I get a 6. And you fail. So you're going to take a hit. I get plus 1 on my damage. My physical is 13, so 14 or less. What's your armor?
My armor is 2. No, sorry, 3.
Well, I might actually have a viral close combat weapon. Let's just check. I do. So actually you're using your BTS. What's your BTS?
BTS on her is also 3.
Okay, so beat a 10. 11 because I have the plus 1. So you fail. You have to beat it. And that's going to give you a wound. You have 2.
I do.
Moira?
Just 1.
All right, so you go straight to dead.
All right.
Viral. So I have to use a command point now to reform the Link. And I'm going to making the Kumatil the Link Leader. She's going to go 4 inches to here. Again, the smoke blocking all the line of sight. He's going to go 4 inches to the other side of here. Again, there's a cloud right here. The Kumatil is going to go 4 inches backwards, like so. So no arrows, second short skill, going to move 4 again. Over like this. We're going to move into this corner, everybody maintaining zone of control. She is the Link Leader. And he will move 4 over to here, like so. We're gonna flip the regular order. And Diplomat is going to move. You're not facing me right now.
No, I'm not.
Which is nice. So she's going to move 4. Now you can attempt ARO change facing if you'd like at physical -3.
Okay.
Because I did activate inside your zone of control. So if you'd like to do that, you can, or you can stay facing where you are. Nope, okay.
Stay where I am.
And then we're going to move 4 again, just to get around the corner. Like here.
Flip everything back.
So that's turn. We go to bottom of 3 now.
Okay, so hang on, what have I got?
You're in LOL. These smoke clouds are going to expire. So you're in Lost Lieutenant. And that means everybody's going to be irregular. And Impetuous, of course, you're Impetuous guys.
Impetuous. I'm just gonna put this other one over here because
sounds good.
Irregular, and then everyone else just gets irregulars.
That's right. So everybody else gets irregulars as well.
Okay.
So he'll stay irregular.
Just 2.
That's right. So irregular and irregular.
Yeah. So I'll just do something with those up.
Yeah. Well, that's gonna go right there.
It's gonna spend all 3 last turn. So this one's gonna become regular. This one's gonna become regular. And this one's going to become regular.
Okay, and that puts 3 regular orders in the order pool.
Yep.
And no lieutenant, obviously, because you don't have... Here's going to be the Kumatil, so that means run around the corner when you come.
Yep.
And Yeah, first short skill is going to be to move as close to that as you can. And that means I'm going to shoot you with this guy.
Yeah, so 4 inches. So she's going to be out there.
Okay, well, machine gun's going to do what machine gun do. Now you're within 16. What would you like your second short skill to be?
Dodge.
Okie doke. I'm going to get to make 4 shots because I have neurocinetics. I'm at +0, but you're in the open. I need to hit on 12s here. That's an 11 and a 5. See if you can dodge it. You need 13 or less. 12 or 13 does it. 9. So you're going to cancel my 5 and take 1 HMG hit. So damage is 15.
Alright.
Your armor 1. I
remember this stuff by now. So.
Beat a 14. You do not, and you go unconscious. She actually had no wound incapacitation, which means she's still awake. She's just dead. She ignores the null state of unconscious and keeps fighting, which is super handy for you, which means you can keep pouring orders, and she'll contest this zone. You're going to need more to break that up, but you get some points in that zone at least. The other impetuous guy right here.
We turn that. Oh, no, wait. Still the impetuous move.
Yep. Right. And she still has her regular as well.
Okay, so she's going to obviously just move 1 inch up to that guy.
Okay.
Well, and that's going to get an arrow
HMG. From him. Yeah, HMG you. I'll HMG you while you're not in cover. So that will be, let's just see if you're over 6. +3. And I'll shoot you while you're in the open, cover around the corner. So I need 15s or less with 4 dice. I assume you're dodging.
I am.
Okay, well, you're going to need to crit and beat a 14 or a 12. So 13 or less? Nope. You take a wound automatically, and then you have to make 2 more armor rolls while you're unconscious to see if you live or not. So beat a 15 twice. Sorry, a 14 twice. You do once and you don't the second time, so she's going to go straight to dead.
Okay.
We're on to regular orders and 1 irregular order now, which is gone because she's dead. So you have 3 regular orders in the order pool that you bought with CPs.
Yep.
And some zones to claim. So right now I have 2 zones. You have 1 zone.
Yep.
The question is, how do you claim these zones? You can easily just move him off the wall here to claim the zone to get up to 2. But then we're tied. You somehow need to get a zone and another zone, but you only have 2 models to do it with.
Yeah, so it can't be done.
So it can't be done. So we're going to tie on zones this time around. Sorry, unless you get in and jam up this zone, and then you get this zone, and I get 1. Okay. You can actually claim all 3 zones, but you're going to have to Rambo all the way over here.
Yes, you can. I'm just checking. You've got these 2 here and these 2.
That's right.
Yeah.
So if he gets into this zone and survives, all he has to do is get into that zone. I only have 1 to your 2.
Okay, so he needs to be just here.
Yep, he needs to climb down a wall and then move up to like over halfway. So on the other side of this crate, basically. So first regular order, he's going to try and move up to the edge because he has to move to the edge before he can climb down.
Yeah, so that's going to be, so it's within.
Yep.
He's 6'4". So there. And then.
So the second order, you're going to go down.
Yep.
And then third order, you can move 10 inches in any direction you want.
Okay, so that's...
That's 1, 2. So 1 up to the edge.
Yeah.
2 to go down, because it's a long skill to go down.
And oh, okay.
You can't do it as part of another skill.
Long skill to go down.
And then now you can move 6-4.
6-4, which will, 10 get puts me up there, which puts me in the next zone. And obviously, suppression fire is done.
So there we go. At the bottom of 3, we're going to count quadrants. You've got 1, 2, because this health cat's going to take this one, because he's more points than him. I've got... 1 now, because you come over and domed with the iguana. So that's going to give you 3 CPs, putting you at 7, so 6 plus 1. I had 1 plus 2 for the 2 consoles I've hacked at the end of the game, because I got these 1-2 consoles. I did not get my classified objective. I believe you did.
Yep.
I got a coup de grace. Yep. That puts you at 8. And that's game. 8-3, victory for Nomads.
So there we go. First game of Infinity. What do you think?
I enjoyed it. Love learning new. Probably should have read the rulebook first.
Well,
the N3 rulebook.
Yeah, you've read rulebooks before. It's not like this is a game that I think you can really learn the meat of by reading about it.
There's a lot that, let me say, like I spent the weekend, listening to Maya Cast and the Krug. And lots of great info there, but it's so much theory hammer and it's so much... so many new
acronyms.
Speaking
in acronyms?
Yeah.
ARO, the end of UI with the whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a lot easier to learn to play a game like this, I think, by actually doing it.
Yeah, this is a learn by play.
I kind of coached you in the beginning by talking about how half of this game is doing what you want to do in the active turn and then preparing for the reactive turn. And I off-camera, guys, I gave him kind of a lot of advice about his iguana and stuff. And how it's not necessarily, when he's so order starved, it's not necessarily the thing that it's doing during the active turn that's positive, especially in supremacy.
Yeah.
But having it hold a whole quadrant, watch a console, and then late game push into a zone to earn you 3 objective points was huge.
That was huge, yeah.
At the end of this game, if he hadn't done that, we would have tied.
Yep.
Because you'd be down two.
Yeah.
Actually, you'd have won by one. You'd have been down two to six, and I would be up an additional one. So I would have been at one, two, three, four. Actually, sorry, it wouldn't have. Yeah, it wouldn't have mattered.
Still would have.
We would have tied. We would have tied for zones. It would have been
tied for zones, but yeah.
And that's. I think that's a really big deal. Is that this is a game that's not just about what you're doing when you're acting. It's about what your pieces are and where they're positioned for when you're reacting to your opponents during the arrows.
Yeah.
So we were talking a little bit about what he wants to add next. You're actually going to be playing in my Infinity Escalation League.
I am.
Which I'll be doing for Mini Wargaming. So I think some stuff to think about with line troops and with little bits and pieces of stuff that generate more control.
Absolutely.
Because the Morlocks are super cool, but we had to use them as combis for the filler. So they weren't the awesome 6-point shock troops that they normally are in this list. You also got some really hot metachemistry rolls for them.
Oh, that was ridiculous. Yeah.
Getting no incapacitation, two clawing pluses, and a 8-4
The 8-4 move. Yeah. That guy just, like, first turn, he was in close combat. That's
pretty awesome. Yeah,
it was pretty nice.
So, yeah. So we hope you guys enjoyed that. You'll probably see more of Mike on the MWG Mini Wargaming channel. I'm not going to use acronyms. I hate using acronyms. hopefully he'll be back at some point to play me, too, after hours.
Absolutely.
Thanks for watching, guys. For more Radio Free NeoTerra, stay tuned, and we'll see you then. Happy Wargaming.
Cheers.